The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
Hive has the dual engine, as we're talking about. We've got this incredible 24 exahash of Bitcoin mining capacity, which is pushing off cash from those operations. And we're using that cash to build up our high-performance computing data centers.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by HIVE Digital Technologies Chief Financial Officer, Darcy Daubaras. Darcy, very good to speak with you. HIVE's October production has a record 289 Bitcoin, and that's up sharply year over year. How are these production gains translating into cash flow and margins, especially with network difficulty at all-time highs?
Yeah, thanks for having me, Stephen. It's an exciting time, as we've seen at HIVE, with the expansion we've been able to do down at Paraguay and driving this expansion that we've got with, you know, record 289 Bitcoin produced in October, going from 6 exahash to where we are now at 24 and having installed at 25. It's producing a lot of good cash flow coming out of there. You know, we had been at, adding an exahash almost every single week for the last couple months. And this expansion is going to, and the cash that's coming from this expansion is going to help us continue to build upon our ASIC and Bitcoin mining capacity. The electricity costs, which everyone in this industry knows is a large part of our overall costs, is good and low down in Paraguay, building off of the largest hydroelectric dam in the Western Hemisphere. So we're extremely excited with the support and the open arms that we've had down in Paraguay. And we're continuing to work with the local energy distribution there called ANDE and the local government to see what other kind of opportunities that we can get down there. It's extremely exciting. We've got an incredible team down there, and we're looking to continue this growth, whether it's in Paraguay or other places, making sure, as we have since day one, that it's green energy, working on hydroelectricity, whether it's in Sweden, Canada, or now down in Paraguay.
And Darcy, you've described Bitcoin mining as the engine funding Hive's move into Tier 3 plus AI and also HPC data centers. How's Bitcoin mining helping to finance this transformation?
Yeah, no, incredible question, Stephen. You know, Hive has always been working with GPUs. And when we started as an Ethereum miner back in 2017, and GPUs is the driver for the high performance computing data centers. A lot of our companies out there are either doing one or the other. They're either doing complete Bitcoin or they're doing high performance computing. And there's a lot of announcements that people are making that they're going to be doing this incredible growth in high performance computing, but they've got no revenue. They may not even have any assets. Hive has the dual engine, as we're talking about. We've got this incredible 24 exahash of Bitcoin mining capacity, which is pushing off cash from those operations. And we're using that cash to build up our high-performance computing data centers. We've already got Tier 3 facilities that were hosted in Montreal and in Sweden. And with the announcement in July of the acquisition of a data center in Toronto, which we closed in September. And we're also taking our capacity that we have in New Brunswick, which has an 80 megawatt transformer, about 70 megawatts of capacity, and in phases looking to build that into Tier 3 compute. And what that's doing is using that funding from the Bitcoin, as we talk about, as a dual engine. We're not just one or the other. They're working together to produce the thrust that we need to move the company forward, and having these revenues to be able to build it in a way that is controllable. And as Hive has always done, we don't go out with a big bang. We make sure that we keep it under control, low debt in the past, and we're hoping to continue to have that, is to build a very strong balance between the two. High-performance computing is a lot more stable once you've got it up and built than the Bitcoin mining. As we know over the years, Stephen, you've seen it, the volatility is there. We can't control the price of Bitcoin. So you've got the high-performance computing, which will be much more stable. And we're looking to continue to build that within Canada because there's a lot of demand for, as they call, sovereign high-performance computing data center. If you're a company that's getting funding from Canada, you want to make sure that you're using Canadian companies. and keep your data within the walls of Canada. And it's very important for those institutions to be able to say that to their shareholders.
Darcy, Hive now controls over 2% of the global Bitcoin network with fleet efficiency around 17.5 joules per terahash. How does that efficiency compare with peers? And what's your plan to maintain or improve it as the industry consolidates?
Yeah, you know, in terms of our comparison to our peers, we're one of the more efficient ones out there. What we're finding is a lot of our peers aren't reinvesting in high performance computing, Bitcoin mining, more efficient miners. They've been, you know, using older versions, the very efficient miners that we've put down in Paraguay that we've gotten from Bitmain are extremely efficient. We've always had an approach to upgrade our miners on a regular basis. This goes back a couple of years where we would be looking for opportunistic miners that we could buy, move them around our fleets to make them as efficient as possible. So it's something that we'll continue to do. You know, we've got very efficient miners down in Paraguay. We're looking constantly at our fleet elsewhere and finding where are those opportunities that we can buy some new miners to continue to reduce that fleet efficiency, make them more efficient, and make our operations more, I don't want to say foolproof, that's the wrong word, but you need to continue to upgrade on your miners as the difficulty continues to increase. And having 2% of the mining network and being able to maintain that over the last couple months while difficulty has continued to go through the roof is a huge badge of honor for our operations team and everybody involved at Hive.
Well, Darcy, congratulations again on your latest stats. I hope you'll continue to keep us updated with your progress.
Absolutely, Stephen. Thank you very much and enjoy your day.
And you. Darcy Daubaras, he's Chief Financial Officer at Hive Digital Technologies.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.